very much. We now to the next speaker, Mr. Lakshmi Narayan. Are you on, Mr. Lakshmi Narayan? Yeah, Mr. Lakshmi Narayan, can you unmute yourself so we can hear you?
Also.
Yes, connected, but he has
unmuted. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Mr. Lakshmi Narayan?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. So, welcome to our Ichama webinar for the 17th of March. It is about lean management, and you will enlighten us about 1S and 2S. So, okay. I pass the line to you, Mr. Lakshmi Narayan, please take over.
Thank you so very much, sir. It's an honor to be a part of this program. And good evening, everyone. I'm Lakshmi Narayan. Can I have the presentation, please? Or do you want me to tell?
Yes. About I will start.
Okay, please start. In the meantime, okay. So as the subject goes, today I'm going to have a brief presentation about the 1S and 2S, which is the basic two steps of 5S, which is a Japanese concept. The most of you must be familiar with the 5S. So in that respect, for how many people 1S and 2S approach is the new approach? I just want to know.
Yeah, for how many people is 1S and 2S a new subject?
Or everyone is aware about this subject?
Is everybody aware?
I think, yeah, everybody is aware about it.
Okay,
good. Whoever is in manufacturing.
Yeah, there are about 16 members and all 16 are aware of 1S and 2S. So please continue.
Great, sir. So everyone is aware. So in that case, okay. Okay, I just go through the slides and then we'll have a question and answer session. So out of 5S, 1S, 2S are the first two steps which help us to keep our organization safe and sound. And it aims to remove waste from the organization. It provides reduction in non-value-added activities. So can somebody explain here, what do I mean by non-value-added activity?
Yeah, the floor is open. Can anybody explain their understanding of non-value-added activities?
Those activities which does not increase the value of the product, or maybe it does not goes to the customer. Whatever activities carried out which does not goes to the customer is non-value-added activities.
Yes, sir, you are partially right. Absolutely. Yes, it does not add value, and more appropriately, for which the customer is not willing to pay. Any activity for which the customer is not willing to pay is a non-value-adding activity, such as segregation. Customer does not, will to pay for the segregation or rework activities. But these are the non-value-added activities. Okay, great, sir. Thank you so very much for your response. And the third point is, it provides an environment where continuous improvement is embraced. So 1S, 2S and 5S, these are the approach where continuous improvements has taken up. People are learned to have Kaizen, because Kaizen is nothing but continuous improvements. It improves safety. It increases quality. Okay, in the question and answer session, I'll explain if somebody has a question, how does 1S, 2S approach improve safety and quality? Can we have the next slide, please? So 1S, what is 1S? In Japan, it is called CD. In English, it is called short. So when it comes to short things, okay, let's take a household example. What we do before Diwali? We clean our house. So when we clean our house before Diwali, that is nothing but the sorting. We clean, okay, we segregate what is needed, what is not needed before Diwali. That is sorting. So in sorting, there are various things we need to take care. Number one is we need to identify what is that thing we need all the time. Number two, what we need occasionally and what we think we might need in future, but we are not sure. And what we think we no longer need it. The one which is no longer needed, we can scrap it. We can dump it. So as the note says, never assume. Everyone is in agreement to check to make sure that what you need, what you think becomes, you know. All I need to say, you don't assume that it is not needed. Everyone has to be in agreement that this document is needed or not needed. Every must be agree that this can be scrapped or not. Redundant items which are no longer needed cost money to storage, because a store keeps needed area, and area does not come free. Okay, it is a cost. Can we have the next slide, please?
Next slide.
For CD. So, how to short things? There are 12 steps which are taken. Number one step. Listen to, you can take this thing, photo of the slide, or I can even share this presentation, whole presentation with you. It's a brief presentation. So, number one step is we need to identify team. Who are going to be the team member of 1-square approach or 5-square approach. So the moment we identify team, we can come to the step two, okay? Event supplies, what are the things we need to for 1S, 2S, okay? We need camera to take before and after photographs. We need paper, we need tagging system, we need red tag. So such items we can collect in step two. And when we are done with it, we can go to the step three, okay, which is we can schedule it when sorting need to be done. Okay, and after scheduling a date, we can identify an area where we can dump the things, and we can decide what to do with them later on. So we local and central holding areas we can identify. In step five, we can set the target, event target. Okay, what is the target of sorting? What are we going to achieve with sorting? What is the objective? Why sorting is needed? And number after this thing, when we achieve the, or when we not to achieve, when we set the target, after setting the target, we can go to the step six, which is set tagging criteria. So we should have a criteria to put red tag on which item. And then we are done with the red tag. We can take a photo of before. Okay, this is the picture of before in our office, shop floor. And after taking photos, because that is going to be very important for a presentation. Okay, this was the before picture of a shop floor. And now this is the shop floor area at level one, level two. Okay, at any this thing, you can identify accordingly. Step eight is red tag those items which are unneeded items. Evaluate what action you are going to do. We need to record what we have scrapped or what we are taking into consideration to retain those documents, paper, and where we have kept them. Okay, where is the later part? Step 10 is disposition the tagged items by assigning actions to the owners. The responsibility part. Step 10 is the responsibility part will take care. And then we can take the photos for the before after board. And then after this is done, we can update the recognition board by the sorting. So we can come to this slide when AMS. Can we have the next slide, please? So one S is done, which is sorting. The second S is sorting, which is we should have a place for everything and everything इन इस प्लेस, हर चीज की एक जगह बनानी है. वी नीड टू नेम इट. जो भी कंपनी, जो भी आइटम इन अ कंपनी इज कमिंग, वेदर स्मॉलर, बिगर, मीडियम साइज्ड, वी शुड हैव अ प्लेस टू कीप इट. Even a nut bolt also. We should have an identified area, place, bin, crate, whatever. We should have an area where we can keep them. So the second S is about making a place where we need to keep them. Okay, I just read out the slide. Put everything in its correct place. But before putting, we need to make the place for every item we have in the organization. In the office, wherever you are doing 1S and 2S. So organize storage for all equipment, that is what are we going to store, where, how many, what is the frequency, and if it is used frequently, keep it closed. And low frequency item needs to be stored offline or far, so that the travel distance can be reduced. The items which are not needed are needed at a very low frequency. Shop organized must have clear walkways, work areas, rest areas, identify areas. Okay, so that help where to go through and how to go, what to, let's say a worker has to go to a toilet. So this helps, okay, this is the walkway, he need to go through that walkway only. So companies do that in shop floor. Consider using different color floor areas to highlight work storage areas. They painted red, they painted green. So based on the policy, they paint accordingly. All essential items such as fire extinguisher, safety equipment must be visible. So before going to the next slide, I just, okay, because I want this session to be very interactive. So to make this in a session very interactive, or I would rather say interactive. So which is the place where the first S is followed without being taught? Can anyone tell me?
Lakshmi Narayan is asking us, which is the first place where 1S is implemented without being taught? Replies, please. Respond.
One S and 2S as well.
Kitchen.
Without being kitchen. Taught. Perfect example, sir. Perfect example. Ladies in the kitchen, they follow 1S and 2S without being taught. They don't know about these, okay, Japanese concepts. Still, they follow it. Still, they follow it. And that saves their time. Perfect, sir. Kitchen is the perfect example at home of 5S. They maintain it. They keep close the things which are needed, lighter, okay, sugar, salt, they keep it close. Perfect example, sir. Thank you so much. Can we have the next slide, please? So as we can see in the photos, so these people have identified a place where to keep the items. Well, let's say these are the tools, wrenches, board, tool board they have made, and they've identified. Okay, I'm not able to zoom it right now, but when we zoom this photograph in presentation, the name is written here. The name is written. This, all I need to say is, it's a place for everything. I know the size of this tool need to be kept here. And the great yellow color kits you can see, okay, on the table. The naming is also done. What need to put on this? The naming is also done on each small crate here. Here, in the second photo, you can see, okay, the naming is also done below this thing, each tool. The tools, this is a tool board. So this is how we can identify area, or in a stable, we can identify a place to keep a tool, fixture, instrument, paper, pen, anything. We need to identify even chair, table. I have seen in many companies, people identify dustbin area, chair area, table area. So this is what is generally followed in the industry. So these are the photos of the 2S, which is a place for everything and everything on its place. So this is a very brief presentation about 1S and 2S, sorting and then making a place and taking decision for discarding. Can we have the next slide, please? Yes, so now I would love to have questions with respect to these 1S, 2S, or any generic question with respect to 5S.
Yeah, the floor is open, and Mr. Lakshmi Narayan wants to have questions from the floor on 1S, 2S, and even on 3, 4, 5S.
And yes, sir.
The point being is that I would just take a small break because 3S is shining everything, dust-free equipment, workplace, dust-free workplace, making it easy to clean and make it easy to inspect abnormal. That's 3S. 4S, standardization, standard procedure for all activities, review of procedures and work instruction at fixed intervals. So I've given you an overview of 3S and 4S. Now the floor is open and request you to give in questions to Mr. Narayan, Lakshmi Narayan. Well, Nimesh, something from your side, please.
Okay, do we really find difficult to implement 5S in our organization? If yes, why? And if it is easy to implement, why we don't find 5S in the organization? Actually, not 5S, even the 3S, first 3S are important. Because see, if we identify area, we short things, even and we don't keep it clean, still it will not look good. So first, 3S are important. The third S, as sir told, Atho sir told, is cleaning. We need to clean the parts, we need to clean the table, chair, everything. So the three S's are important. Fourth is standardize. We need to standardize the defined frequency and sustain it. The fifth is to sustain. So what is the difficult part we feel for implementation of 5S? The most difficult part.
Lakshmi, you can, you know, as much as you'll get in questions, you could also give an overview of what has been your experience because you were at Male and today you are
right.
Yeah. So you've got, you know, experience of a large organization and even MSME. So could you tell us the cultural behaviors that were prevalent, which you have observed, which made people implement 1 and 2S? Tell us everything.
Okay. So, as far as my experience as customer, which I've observed at many places, sir, at my supplier places also, they follow 5S. The most difficult phase of 5S is the fifth one, is sustain, actually. Sustainance is the key, actually. They don't sustain it. I have seen, okay, as the sir asked about the effectiveness of training. Okay, I don't want to go off track. I'll talk about that also. But before that, I'll complete this. The most difficult part is implementing 5S. Okay, as I said, they don't sustain it. People, they come back to the standard they were following. Easiness. Okay, what is easy for them, they follow this thing. Saab ne kya bola, kya nahi bola. Theek hai, 5S pata hai, cheeze jagah pe rakhni chahiye. Still, humko nahi rakhni because, see, nahi rakhni because वो जगह मुझे ठीक नहीं लगा एंड इवन टू सस्टेन इट एक्चुअली वी शुड टेक वर्कर्स इन्वॉल्वमेंट आल्सो 5S इज एन एक्टिविटी वेयर वी नीड इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ एवरीवन बॉटम इट हैज टू बी गो थ्रू एक्चुअली दिस इज नॉट एन टॉप दिस थिंग अप्रोच इट्स एन अप्रोच फ्रॉम बॉटम टू टॉप पीपल फ्रॉम द बॉटम should be a part of 5S. They should be taught and let them do it. Let them decide the area कि आप लोगों को कहाँ पे रखना है ये tool. As ma'am said fixture, तो आप लोग बताओ कि ये fixture कहाँ पे होना चाहिए. Fixture का frequency क्या है. Fixture ये कहाँ पे रखना चाहिए. Gauge हमें कहाँ पे रखना चाहिए. अगर ये वेल्डे की टॉर्च है ठीक है वो तो मशीन के साथ है तो whatever, because see, उनको क्या इजी लगता है but the most important part is जगह होनी चाहिए आप देखो कहाँ पे रखना है बट जहां पे भी आपको लगता है इजी है ठीक है लेटर ऑन वी कैन चेंज इट बिकॉज दैट इज कंटिन्यूअस इंप्रूवमेंट विच विल कीप ऑन गोइंग बट द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट इज जो भी चीजें दिखनी चाहिए उसका नाम होना चाहिए उसके ऊपर और उसकी एक जगह होनी चाहिए लेट देम डिसाइड कभी कभी क्या हो जाता है सुपरवाइजर बोलता है नहीं ये मैंने बनाया है ये मैंने कबर्ड बनाई है ये चीज यहाँ पे होनी चाहिए जो ब्लू कॉलर वर्कर को नहीं जमता नहीं साहब ने जैसा बोला है मेरे को नहीं समझ में आया और मेरे को नहीं चलता मुझे मेरे हिसाब से काम करना है ओके लेट देम डू देम देयर वे बट द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट की इट हैज टू बी फॉलोड और वो फॉलो कब होगा व्हेन ही और शी विल एंजॉय डूइंग इट एंड व्हेन दे विल एंजॉय बिकॉज देयर वे लेट देम डू Five is their way. We need to make sure that it is being followed effectively. And when it will be followed effectively, when they do it their way. We need to make sure ke hona chahiye, shorting honi chahiye, koi bhi unwanted item machine ke paas nahi hona chahiye, table ke paas nahi hona chahiye. This is what we need to tell them. कि है तो वी नीड टू आस्क व्हाई देयर आर आल्सो 5S ऑडिट्स आर आल्सो डन स्कोरिंग इज आल्सो डन एरियाज आर आल्सो आइडेंटिफाइड फॉर 5S इतना बड़ा कंपनी है इतने बड़ी कंपनी की को एक छोटे छोटे एरियाज 5S जोन में बांटते हैं दे कॉल इट जोन जोन 1 जोन 2 जोन 3 जैसे इन माय कंपनी वी डिवाइडेड द कंपनी इन 9 जोन तो जोन 1 का एक लीडर हो गया वो लीडर के अंडर 10 लोगों की टीम है दे और उस जोन को भी हमने 10 डिवीजन बना दिए कि भैया दिस इज योर एरिया ऑफ लाइक 10x10 यू आर द ओनर ऑफ दिस 10x10 एरिया इस एरिया में कुछ भी गंदगी नहीं चलेगा कुछ भी अनवांटेड नहीं चलेगा और हर चीज की नाम होनी चाहिए हर चीज का जगह होना चाहिए सो दैट 10x10 का एरिया में आदमी पे भी बहुत बर्डन नहीं आया एंड इट वॉज डन डिवाइड वी नीड टू डिवाइड इट एक्सक्यूज मी जस्ट So this is how we were able to do it, and most of the organization are also doing it that way. So this was how we were able to do it successfully. Number one. Now come this thing. Coming back to the sir asked the effectiveness of a training. That is a very important question. Look, training देते हैं उसमें पैसा जाता है time जाता है but when it comes to effectiveness कुछ नहीं होता क्योंकि अगर over a period of time हमने क्या जो सिखाया वो तो बंदा कर ही नहीं रहा जो बताया है वो तो हो ही नहीं रहा तो क्या मतलब रह गया वो time का क्या मतलब रह गया वो so the time is money because वो one day गया एक manager का और 5 वर्कर हमने मशीन से उठा के वो 5 मशीन उस दिन किसी और ने चलाई हमने एक ओटी लगाया व्हाटएवर सी द पॉइंट इज वो इफेक्टिवनेस आना चाहिए और वो इफेक्टिवनेस कम आएगा वी नीड टू आस्क अगेन एंड अगेन वी नीड टू आस्क अगेन एंड अगेन ठीक है मैडम वाज सेइंग कि वी ओके के सुपरवाइजर ओके बिकॉज़ सी विन विल लाइक ही सेज गुड मॉर्निंग अच्छा लगता है साहब हमको आके पूछता है हम कैसे हैं हमारे घर वाले कैसे हैं नमस्कार करते हैं आगे से सो दैट इज आल्सो गुड पॉइंट बट व्हेन इट कम्स टू इफेक्टिवनेस फॉलो अप इज नीडेड सर दिस इज इंडिया इंडिया में कोई भी काम बिना फॉलो अप के नहीं होता अगर आप फॉलो अप नहीं लेंगे तो इफेक्टिवनेस नहीं आएगा यू नीड टू आस्क बिकॉज जब हम ट्रेनिंग देते हैं ना तो उसके साइन लेते हैं कि हाँ आपको 3 बजे से 5 बजे तक ट्रेनिंग दिया ना दिस इज द रिकॉर्ड नाउ दिस इज द रिकॉर्ड आपको आपने साइन किया आपको ट्रेनिंग मिला है ना नाउ आपने क्या सीखा मुझे बताइए एक क्वेश्चनेयर है ट्रेनिंग का वो क्वेश्चनेयर को आंसर करो आप वो इफ यू आर एबल टू आंसर दोस क्वेश्चंस 98% तक तो आपको ट्रेनिंग समझ में आया नहीं तो मे बी उसको दिया उसको समझ में नहीं आया सो एवरी ट्रेनिंग शुड हैव अ क्वेश्चनेयर बेस्ड ऑन द क्वेश्चनेयर वी विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मच द पीपल हैव अंडरस्टूड द ट्रेनिंग सो दिस इज व्हाट कैन बी डन क्वेश्चनेयर इन केस अगर वो क्वेश्चनेयर करके बाद फॉलो नहीं कर रहा तो द ओनली वे इज फॉलो that's I ask Rathod sir to take over, or if feel, please feel free if you have any question now.
Yeah, so friends, we have another 8 minutes left, so let's use this time effectively and let's have question and answer session on everything related to 1S and 2S. The floor is open now. I find Girish, can you raise any questions on this subject? Suparia. Mr. Suparia, can I hear some question from you about 1S and 2S? Yeah, unmute Karan. Mr. Suparia?
Hello?
Yes, you're on.
Hello? Yes. No question.
Please, go ahead.
Yes. At present, no question.
Okay, you don't have any questions?
No, thanks.
Okay, right. So, Munal and Munal Kunsala, Muralidhar Kabra, Nimesh, some questions from your side?
No questions, thank you.
Jignesh?
Sir, I have a question for them.
Yes, please. The question is for them. Please, go ahead.
Okay. For them, the question is, how many of them are happy with 1S and 2S, okay, in the organization? Or, okay, more precisely 5S in the organization.
Yeah. So, Lakshmi and Yusuf, Miss Yusuf, one by one, can you answer that question? How many people in your organization are happy in implementing 1S and 2S? Lakshmi, please.
So, sir, this question is for the audience.
Oh, okay, I see.
If they don't have any question, I know this is very basic. People understand 5S. But if they understand, I also assume that they 5S also has in the stage of implementation, or they are following it. So if they are following it, are the owners of the company happy with the 5S?
Who asked that question? I'm sorry, I didn't follow. Who was that who asked?
See, this is for everyone. This question is applicable to everyone who is listening.
Okay, right. So, Lakshmi, I think you are asking everybody in the audience.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. How happy are the participants' companies happy implementing 1S and 2S in their respective organizations? We have roughly about 8 companies over here. So,
right.
I would say that, you know, you could just say yes from your side. There is, I would put in like Jignesh and then...
Yes.
Girish, Mrunal, Muralidhar, Nimesh. These are 6 companies' names that I've taken, and Ravi Chand. Okay, 6. So can you tell us, you know, how happy are your people in implementing 1S and 2S in your companies?
Or they, as the owner, are happy with the people, with the 5S?
Yeah, I think this gives a idea to us that before the next session begins, this is something that we can take back, you know, because what I learned is very interesting, that whatever has been the training given, yes, this is part of the cluster training in itself, including the virtual training, whatever was the training that you have got this morning about this afternoon about TEI and 1S and 2S. Copies of this presentation will be sent to you. And my next session, which is on the 21st April, the first 5 minutes I will ask each participant, how happy, how much implementation have you done of the training that was given to you on the 17th of March? And my recommendation is show this presentation to your HODs first. Let there be a 1 hour session, exactly what we are doing. Let them ask questions to the participants of today's seminar. And after that, let the HODs present it to small groups of 10 in each company, you know. So maybe you've got 30 days, and roughly I can understand there could be about 60 to 100 workers in the respective companies over here. So you have about 10 days in gaps of 2 or 3 days, show the training to groups of 10 and let them ask questions to you as HODs and as promoters, how easy it is, or what are the questions they have to implement this in their respective organization. The success of this webinar and this whole Lean journey will only be that every 30 days you are getting time to train your HODs and your employees, giving them the basics of Lean, and let them implement it, and let us learn some questions that are coming from the respective companies and their employees about implementing a specific subject, in this case being TEI and 1S and 2S. So that will give us an idea that we are doing our best to, you know, bring this to you. But as Ms. Lakshmi has said, and as what Ms. Yusuf also said, unless this doesn't go to the shop floor, which is from promoters to HODs to supervisors and to the workers, unless this message is not reaching out to the worker and the supervisor, our efforts in Lean will be short-circuited, because it's only going to ivory towers and air-conditioned cabins, but unfortunately it's not reaching out to the masses, to the shop floor, and that is one of the biggest hurdles we must overcome. We have 30 days to do a training for all the respective subjects that are being broadcast, and I do look forward to getting your support in, you know, hearing from you how to reach out these subjects, to broadcast them to HODs and to supervisors and even the workers. So we have another 5 minutes. Any questions from anybody on the participants?
The President Rathod, Jignesh Rauf here. Good evening. Jignesh Rauf here. Good evening.
Yes, good evening. Good evening, Jignesh. Go ahead.
I just want to say that in my company, we had implemented Lean some time ago, and in reference to the questions and the comments raised or presented by Mr. Lakshmi, I simply want to say that our workers, we had implemented Lean in the store, in stock keeping and all. We were not able to implement Lean completely, but the overall feeling is that once Lean is implemented at a certain level, there is a level of acceptance that you don't really hear from the workers, but you see it when they start accepting what is happening. In my store, when we had implemented Lean, the initial stage was that अरे ये करना है वो करना है इतना record रखना है इसको label लगाना है इसकी जगह कहाँ है ये नहीं हो सकता वो नहीं हो सकता. But once they have done it, they realize after some time. So the effort to be made from the upper management or the heads has to be such that you keep your patience and you educate your lower level people to that level for that amount of time that they personally can accept, and then have that feel ki nahi isse fayda hota hai. Once you reach that level, then your gadi automatic. So I simply want to say, yes, we have tried in my organization, lean in the store is quite effective. And personally, as an owner, when we visit certain other companies, or when supervisory people, they visit some other companies. For example, we have visited your company, you know, for in Surendranagar. When we get to those places, or especially in foreign countries, we come out with the comment, you know, come out of that visit and say, oh, kitna mast tha. You know, it was nice and clean, and everything was in place, and this and that. Once you implement the 5S system, the first two or three steps, you start getting that feel in your own organization also. This is my comment. Indian system ko hum log koste hain. I'm sorry, I'm just being a little rude. But you see, once we accept it, we also have the same level of possibilities. That is all what I have to say. So, yes.
You know, I think Jignesh has really, you know, got to the bottom of it all, because he has given a live example that he had patience. And because he had the patience, and also he did it in a small department, which was only the stores. So I think this is a very big learning for all of us. He has taken one small step, and he has had the patience as a promoter that I will go the long haul, and I want the people to own it, or rather to accept it. And when they accept it, they start implementing it. And then the demonstration comes maybe over a month or 2 months, where less questions are being asked, but more observations are being made. So I think this is a very big learning for all of us, that at the top, Jignesh being a promoter like many, many of us in this room, when he has taken a very bold risk and a bold challenge that I'm going to be very patient and I will do it in a small department, and I'm waiting to get feedback from them. That I think is a good learning for us. And the question that, what we talked about the Indian way, actually the late Mr. Narasimhan, who you see over here, unfortunately expired in early February. He has written this book and another book called Indian Production System. He was in Japan for more than 5 or 7 years. And then he realized that when I come back to India, there's a big difference between the Japanese and the Indians. So he made this book, he has written this book, because he implemented it in roughly about 200 companies. And this book is a compendium of learning from how Indians think and how to make them think differently. You know, so I do appreciate the questions raised by Jignesh. And I request all of you, please go back to your desk. The Gujarati version is on your hands roughly since around the 10th of March or the 12th of March. Please distribute this to all your people and let them read it, so that, you know, when they read it, they know that when we are all pursuing lean, there is something that can be done as such. Thank you very, very much, Jignesh, for raising some very important questions.
You're welcome, sir.
Anything else? Gentlemen, we are now at 5:30, and I think let's be good Indians by trying to be as Japanese as we can. Let's close this session on time. You will get a copy of this presentation, and if you have any questions, you can raise them to Mr. Mathri, and Mr. Mathri will shoot them out to Ms. Yusuf and to Lakshmi. And just 1 quick minute, anybody has one more question, then we can take one more question, and then we'll close the session as much as on time as we can. 1 quick question from the floor. Well, I now realize that earlier the session used to be, I think, 5 to 6, and I got some feedback. No, 4 to 5:30 is a good time. Let's see, we'll keep it at 4 to 5:30 so that everybody gets back to their desk and or to their respective homes. Keeping that in mind, I would like to thank all the participants for joining us this evening, and a very big, big thank you to Ms. Yusuf and to Lakshmi Narayan for, you know, sharing with us all the long journeys that they have done for the last 15 years in their respective companies and bringing to us something straight from their shop floor to this webinar. Thank you very, very much. And thank you to all the participants. I remind you that 21st April is the next session. The 21st April is the next session, and it will cover four subjects. We are keeping it open. The subjects are Kaizen. Then I would talk of My Machine campaign, absenteeism, and safety. These are the four subjects. I'd be too happy from you people what you would like to cover, so that we'd get, you know, specialists on that subject to roll out on 21st April. But most important is, I've given you some homework and I'd like you to carry that back, read the Gujarati book, and then roll it out to your supervisors and workers in small groups of 10, and let's hear from them how they have implemented 1S and 2S in their companies. Because when you do 1S and 2S, that itself is TEI. Because I'll just read the last, I'll show that to you in this book that I have over here, which is a compendium of all the work done by ACT members. If you go to 5S and the bottom right over here, the benefits of 5S, the last line says total employee involvement. So let's do 1S and 2S, and we know that we would get implementation of TEI. Friends, we'll close the session, and please do the homework that I've given you, and I'll write you a small note and send you that reminder every 15 days. Thank you very, very much. And we see you again on the 21st April at 4 p.m. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.